God have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Lord God, that we who serve as we rejoice in an unfailing health of mind and body, and after the glorious intercession of the Blessed Mary, your Virgin, may we be set free from present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the beginning of the first book of Samuel. There was a certain man from Ramathaim, the line of Elkanah by name, a Zuphite from the hill country of Ephraim. He was the son of Jeroboam, son of Abihu, son of Tohu, son of Zub, an Ephraimite. He had two wives, one named Hannah, the other Hananiah. Hananiah had children, but Hannah was childless. This man regularly went on pilgrimage from his city to worship the Lord of hosts and to sacrifice to him at Shiloh, where the two sons of Eli, Hophni and Phinehas, were ministering as priests of the Lord. When the day came for Elkanah to offer sacrifice, he used to give a portion to each, to his wife, Hananiah, and to all her sons and daughters, but a double portion to Hannah because he loved her, though the Lord had made her barren. Her rival, to upset her, turned into a constant reproach to her that the Lord had left her barren. This went on year after year, each time they made their pilgrimage to the sanctuary of the Lord. Hananiah would approach her, and Hannah would weep and refuse to eat. Her husband, Elkanah, used to ask her, "Hannah, why do you weep, and why do you refuse to eat? Why do you grieve? Am I not more to you than 10 sons?" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To you, Lord, I will offer a sacrifice of praise. To you, Lord, I will offer a sacrifice of praise. How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. To you, Lord, I will offer a sacrifice of praise. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosed my bonds. To you, Lord, I will offer a sacrifice of praise. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in your midst, O Jerusalem. To you, Lord, I will offer a sacrifice of praise. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe the gospel. As he passed by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting their nets into the sea. They were fishermen. Jesus said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." Then they left their nets and followed him. He walked along a little farther and saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They too were in a boat mending their nets. Then he called them. So they left their father Zebedee in the boat, along the higher end, and followed him. The gospel of
churches, in our city, in our world, the great indwelling of the Holy Spirit. Today, we entrust all of our churches, ourselves, to Mary, the Mother of the Church, she who was there from the very first moment of the beginnings of the Church. She is our Mother and our Guide. Pray, brothers.